Hi, I'm Luca Ferrara. I'm a sandboxer. I have been for a couple of years. I joined the team when I was actually already at Google. I did a 20% project where basically Google says, hey, why don't you take about a fifth of your time, find something interesting that you can work on, and we'll see where that goes. I actually originally only got 1 month of approval to do that. I ended up doing it for 12. And the reason I ended up doing it for 12 is that I just kept finding myself really, really interested in what I was learning with the SandboxAQ team. And I just really couldn't stop, even if maybe I should have. I'm really happy that I followed that curiosity because I was able to go from meeting and understanding the SandboxAQ team to really becoming part of it. And then now, as I've transitioned fully to Sandbox and I've been leading a team on the navigation side, trying to help the team forward. So you go from hearing about a thing to helping with a thing to being a real integral part of that thing. And it's been really rewarding to do. What advice would I give someone that's, you know, interested in joining the AQ revolution or is just starting out in AQ? You'd be surprised at how far your curiosity and what you know can get you and how far you'll go just based off of that. Whether it's AI or quantum, if there's an application that resonates with you, whether it's drug discovery, quantum sensing, quantum security, any of these other areas, and there's a lot of areas where a quantum or AI technology might have an impact. If you have that application in mind, it'll draw you in, especially if you're, you know, a bit nerdy, which I consider myself. It's really fun to learn about how something like a photon can end up leading to some kind of insight that helps a person. And then when you join a business or a startup like SandboxAQ, you might even learn about how does helping that person lead to a business model. And so depending on what you want to do, there's a lot of different ways you can be part of the revolution. Not everybody needs to be a scientist, not everybody needs to be an engineer. There's plenty of them and they're great, I work with them. But a lot of the impact I've been able to have actually has not been from that. And so I would encourage people to not say no to themselves and follow their curiosity if there's an application area where they think AI or quantum could have an impact. So have I ever experienced imposter syndrome or self-doubt in my career? Yes. Have I found ways to overcome it? Think so. The truth is that if you keep pushing yourself and you keep putting yourselves into rooms where you're not the smartest person, that feeling might come back and back again. But I hope that I've been developing the tools where I actually know and have the confidence to know that if I follow my learning plan and I have the right attitude, I will end up kind of dispelling that feeling. I think in everybody's careers, there's a moment where you have to potentially take a big leap of faith or a big risk. And when I was in business school, I was taking an entrepreneurship class from a professor who, in the first day of class, said, careers are decided in moments of very high leverage. And that really has stuck with me. And there's a moment I can really define, and I even went back to this professor to talk about this personal moment, where Sandbox was on its way out of Google. I was at Google, I had transferred, my personal story was I had transferred to the team within X. Shortly after that, we made our transition out of Alphabet. But I had the decision to make about, at that point in time, was it better for me to, you know, stay the place I had gone straight after my MBA or to follow on with the team out? And it was a, you know, a decision that I knew I needed to take seriously. I knew I felt a certain way about it and my gut said, go. But I knew that I really need to have a clear reason for doing this so that I have the confidence that even when things get tough, that it was the right decision for me. And so the decision to be one of the first people to sign my contract at Sandbox and to commit early to the mission that we're on was ultimately what I decided to do. But there's a lot of people, I think, that for good reasons, they might be in a position in their career where taking that startup risk or that emerging deep tech risk, it's maybe not the right time for them. I think at Sandbox, maybe more than anywhere I've been, and I've been at some places that claim to be about growth and development, really at Sandbox AQ, it is in our blood and our culture. and continuous professional development is just kind of in the air, I would say. You'll often hear people talking about what they're working on in their learning plan. Sometimes it's something exciting. Some people on my team are learning to fly. Some people are learning to do martial arts. Some people are learning guitar, and they're committing to playing guitar in the subway a couple of times, or posting YouTube videos. And when they do it, they share it with us, and it's super rewarding for them and really encouraging for us. But other times we're focused on learning things that are really relevant to our job. We're working in an area where the technology is advancing really rapidly. AI is moving at a really rapid pace, quantum at an increasing pace. And so if you're going to be knowledgeable and on the bleeding edge of those industries, you really can't rest on your laurels, so to speak, and assume that whatever you've learned up until that point, whether it's a PhD, master's, or whatever amount of industry expertise, you don't want that to go stale. And I also think that what we've identified or what we might be onto at SandboxAQ is that in today's world, a lot of people, they get a lot of intrinsic value out of working at somewhere that wants them to grow. And I think that a lot of us, if we were to reflect on a particular role in our career that we didn't love, we might describe it as something like being a dead end or somewhere where I wasn't growing anymore. And so one of the ways that we try and make sure that people get a lot of intrinsic benefit from being here is encouraging people to have a growth plan and focus on professional growth, personal growth, education, and the management, you know, folks like myself and my colleagues, we take it seriously. And we want to ask the question to our teams, have you taken the time this month to find a little bit of time to work on your learning plan? How is your professional development going? You know, where do you want to be, and what can we set as a goal for you this year that gets you closer?